Welcome back.
We are mid-battle. It's all happening. We are in the hull of the enemy ship. Some kind of pirates are attacking our fleet. We think.
You've just skewered some one of dude them. In the back.
Bum was what the chat wanted. They wanted a bottom skewer.
That's what they wanted.
Wow.
There was even, I believe, a Japanese terminology for it. But anyway.
Okay, what's that? Because that has to be part of my daily vocabulary.
The Japanese.
That would be, if I interpreted it correctly, that would be the Kakashi to Naruto. If that is what that means, Whistling Whiskers, please tell me, otherwise we will be using it wrongly and people will be looking at us, especially people of Japanese origin.
And the Japanese people will say, what do you mean wrong hole?
Oh, see, I'm not that bad.
Derek.
Sorry.
Okay.
I bring the class. That's
Johnny.
I bring the class.
Johnny. Yeah.
That needs
discipline.
To be a t-shirt.
Cool.
I'm going to start gravity raging soon.
Gravity raging.
Alright.
Our initiative order, just so I'm clear, it goes Murray, then the two NPCs, then us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Except it
goes Derek, Nathan, then me.
Yeah, yeah. So I think we're up to your turn.
Okay.
But in the moment between your turns in the initiative order, I'm going to bring a GM intrusion upon you.
Yes!
Is this an intrusion upon an intrusion?
It is.
What level of intrusion is it?
Oh, I don't know.
Just say three.
What?
That's much higher than one.
I think it's one, two, or three, isn't it?
Yeah, but three's like super epic, isn't it?
It's saying we're quieter now.
Oh, Jonathan's up. Yeah, it's really quiet.
Oh. How did we get quiet? Is the mic...
Is that better, guys?
2-2-1, isn't it?
Yeah, good. No. Cool.
Awesome. So, how do the levels work? I can't remember. That's why I need to read the rules.
Make the two, and just make it like a... It's two experience points, essentially, and you ask me whether I want to take it or not.
Yeah, alright.
And so, I can either expend an XP to say no, or I can accept it.
And then you get these.
And I get these, but I have to live with the ramifications.
Yeah.
Well, Johnny, I believe I will accept your GM intrusion.
And take the 2XP.
Yeah!
Sorry for your ears, 3Pod.
Yeah.
That hurt.
Well, sorry.
It suddenly got louder.
No, he was listening to us on headphones.
And then he turned the volume up.
Oh, that's awful, sorry.
Should have given you warning.
Why does our audio always suck? I blame Nathan.
I blame Nathan.
I blame Nathan.
No, all the audio stuff is mine. I blame Nate.
Whoops, apparently that was quite loud.
Alright. Cool, so... in that moment,
we'll fix it in post.
Before you can attack Murray's assailant, and in the moment when your
sorry, 3Pod,
your force gravity thing. Oh yeah, you can share that, can't you?
Yeah. Leave it to Derek because he hasn't got any.
Yay!
And because you're awesome, Derek, and we're buddies.
That's right.
In the game, not so much in real life.
No. In fact,
cool.
So my gravity thing's going.
So your gravity three thing missed and hit the machine somewhere.
Yeah.
And in that, that split second moment to act, and he's going to act between your turns, out of turn, to press a button on the machine that sets off this alarm ringing.
So there's people to kill, and you push the Numenera.
Yeah.
Did you push it with your nose?
Yeah.
Tongue.
Okay. Oh. A gentleman uses his tongue.
Yeah, yeah. So, and you hear shouts from up above and footsteps on the metal staircase.
It's so beautiful, the music.
I wish I had an alarm. Hang on. There should be one here, shouldn't there?
Can I start calling the ship? Just connecting with it?
Oh, nice. Or the machine.
Your ship from below?
Yeah, yeah.
What are you going to do to it?
I'm just going to start saying to start moving up to the level that we're on the side.
Ooh,
so if we do need to run through the wall, we can.
Well, I can blow a hole. It's all good.
That won't let any water through.
Yeah. Small problem of water, Murray.
No.
Cool. Okay. So, yeah, you hear...
That's my action.
pressing the button.
Press the button,
and,
mate.
And getting
excellent.
You to XP. Yep.
Excellent. Yeah, yeah. No, I was just making sure I was clear. Yeah.
All right. So now I think it's Murray's turn.
Sorry. Sorry. Can we just pause?
Oh.
When you get XP, you have to give it to some. To you have to give one of it to another player. Is that right?
That's correct.
And if you got three XP, you would have to give two.
No, I think I just give one.
Or just one.
You keep the other
two.
Yeah. It's been a while since I've read that bit.
Yeah. That's why I understood
3 years
it as well.
Or something.
I'm just kind of curious as to why.
It's just a way of
sharing
it around, and
yeah.
And you also meant to give a reason why, like. The way that you brought us through the wall is the reason why I'm going to give you your experience. I
right.
thought that was a good play, story building.
Okay, so you're rewarding me.
In it, so it's about.
So it doesn't have to be
community.
Something that happened right then.
No, it could be
generally.
You saved my butt earlier in a really epic story
right.
kind of way, and that was great.
Right,
that's cool.
I'm
like
going to take my calligraphy pen that's blocked him, and then I'm going to stab him in the neck with the calligraphy pen.
And paint with his blood.
Yep. Oh. Alright, some blood. Are
you gonna
make a roll?
Nope. Oh, we know what that's called.
Six plus two.
What is going on with our dice rolls
all
at the
right.
moment? It's amazing.
You, how much damage does a calligraphy pen do?
I don't have stats for how
that
much damage does a calligraphy.
I think
that would be a
but
two.
It's for the jugular.
It's
causing
right?
him,
so
it's causing
like
him some
one.
Massive issues.
No,
so
it's two. What's that? Two plus
two.
Two.
Really two.
Light weapon.
Oh, yeah,
two
yeah,
plus
yeah,
one?
Light weapon.
No, you got a plus two, didn't you?
Oh yeah, two plus two. Four.
Yeah.
Yeah. So he's not looking well, but he maybe has a little bit of life left in him.
Right, do I have
You can also expend effort to boost the damage or to hit more accurately.
Oh, that's
so just to let you know. But,
right,
but
we can't
it's
do
too late
that
now, but I'm just saying like that's something which we can do.
Yeah, but I heard him and I've got some lovely red ink now, so I'm good.
Cool. So he
you should draw with it, I say.
I'm gonna paint on the machine. You want me.
He sort of wildly swings his sword in your general direction. He's hardly even looking, but you're standing close enough that he may.
Mm-hmm.
He's sort of just
while he's
crashing out.
I don't notice because I'm still hung up on how cool my stabbing him in the neck with my calligraphy pen worked. He gets a 5 plus 1.
No, you get a 5.
You
plus
get a
5.
I get a 5 plus 1 on my dodge.
So you successfully dodge his wild
with a laugh
swing.
is this guy a human or an abhuman?
I think he's human, but.
I think as a GM you'd probably know.
He's got a lot of like his
human
tentacles.
No. But like his skin is almost looks like it's got sort of tattooing but like everywhere in these sort of swirling patterns all over his skin.
Okay.
But there's nothing else about him that's particularly abhuman.
Yeah,
so
okay.
He might just be a very, very heavily tattooed human.
Is his the blood spurting out of his artery? Is it spurting out in a normal heartbeat kind of way, or is it spurting out in a strange way? Is it spurting?
It is. Yeah, it is spurting, and it looks like regular blood.
Excellent.
For all you know at the moment, you can assume it's just
regular
human
blood.
Cool. I just wanted everyone to think about that for a moment. That there's blood spurting out of an artery.
It's
mm-hmm.
good.
Yeah, in a heartbeat.
He's not looking well.
My pen's full.
Like one of those old movies where they have the hose behind, and it's just like.
He
that was a hose?
His desperate swing at Murray, which Murray deftly dodged.
And laughed.
He sort of follows through and collapses on the ground and doesn't look like he's probably going to get up again.
Oh, okay.
But the footsteps are very close, coming down the gangplanks, and you're about to have company.
Can you identify the piece of... Is there like a key node that we could rip out of this and
I can
disable
make a Numenera.
Yeah,
go
for
it. I could do that. Is it my turn?
Yeah.
Nathan's.
No, but he could wait.
I'll wait.
Oh, no, you guys could act and then I'll just go. Like, it doesn't make a difference if you wait or not.
They don't have anyone to attack because everyone's...
Yeah, okay, cool.
I might go to the stairs.
There's guys on the stairs. Yeah, you could
can
go
we push,
and...
Can I use gravity to push the gangplank up so it's actually not... They can't get down the stairs.
Ooh.
With my, I've got the ability push, because I'm a gravity.
I was going to squirt ink in there first.
Yeah, I'll let you make a roll to push.
Push.
You're trying to knock the gangplank
so,
down, or
no? Push it up so it's like, so instead of it going like this, it goes poof, and
oh,
just
yeah.
holding it there with
so
gravity.
It becomes like a door.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
That's cool.
I like that idea. That's cool.
One.
You fail. It seems like it's bolted too well into the floor for you to dislodge it and lift it up.
Okay, I am completely like looking over this thing, but I'm not looking for an answer for you guys. I'm distracted. So if you want me to do something, you might need to try and convince me to focus.
So I'll say to you, find me the power source and I will rip it out for you. And we can take it with us.
And we can add it to our own?
Totally. You could even have a lick of it if you wanted.
Take what you need, Rin. Take what you need.
I will need time. And a little bit of alone. I'm going to close my eyes and then open them. And my eyes turn into translucent orbs as I open my eyes to the unseen. And I'm just basically going to press my face up against the against the computer. And I'm just going to start whispering to the little round... What's that like ear horn kind of thing that they were speaking into?
Yeah.
I'm just going to start whispering to the machine and, you know, and sensing and tasting and touching it. And my eyes are like flicking all over it. So I'd like to explore it with Numenera.
Go for it. Make it roll.
So I'm skilled in it at the moment because it's reflex skill. So... what's the diff? Oh, do you want to tell me?
Make it difficulty 4.
Okay, so it's diff 3. And then I'm going to use my effort to drop it down to diff 2. So that's going to cost me 2. So it's going to be 13. And I'm also using the See the Unseen, so I don't know if that gives me any other bonus on top of that.
Oh, what a good idea.
Yeah. I suppose it does, doesn't it? Because that's separate to your...
This is my ability, yeah. Yeah, this is my skill, that's my ability.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
it's diff 1.
Diff 1, yeah.
Okay.
Makes it easy.
Roll a 1.
In your mind's eye, in your...
My mind palace.
Sight, you see that this machine is not held together by... Like, the mechanism is not with gears, it's all liquid. It's probably like hydraulic or something like that.
Yes.
And there's all these different tubes and pipes running all different directions with liquids running up and down them in every direction. It's really like highly pressurized. And right at the center of this kind of maze of tubes and pipes is this glowing sort of orb. And that's the spot, that's the key, you think. And it's sort
I
of...
I have found it!
It's like a glowing orb, but like it's like suspended in a vacuum, I guess. Like, it's not like the orb's there with the tubes attaching directly to it. There's an orb and then a space, maybe a meter diameter sphere, that's like right in the heart of the machine with this orb in it.
Okay, I grab Flair's face and I go like this and I look into your eyes. You can see the translucent eyes and you see exactly where it is. It's in the middle. I'm like got your face. It's in the middle.
Okay.
Must move through walls.
Yeah.
And like madness is just like pouring out of my eyes.
So yeah,
move
like
through walls.
Maybe like 3 meters away from
so
you.
Insane,
there's a 1 meter diameter space that you could probably move into.
Okay.
Get me the power source, Flair. Get it for me.
I start hopping back and forth on alternating my feet.
Hilarious.
And I start giggling.
I'll peel my fingers back.
leaving this in this direction.
Dice.
But the dots are mad. They're like got little dots all over them. So
right.
They're like dice imprints.
So I guess. Feet
are coming down the gangplank. While all this is happening.
Yeah. So for you two, as you're about to... I can't remember who we're up to. We're up to them and then... No, you and then.
Me, then, them.
Yeah. So you see feet kind of appearing...
Straight through their foot.
Just at the top of the gangplank.
I pull out my mirror and I'm going to wait until just before his foot's going to touch the next step and then I put my mirror under his foot.
No, it makes him step through...
There's usually, just to make it more complicated, there's usually a level for ciphers or artifacts where they'll fail after a certain amount,
mm-hmm.
And so it's usually like 1 in 20 rolls, if you're like 1,
A normal D20?
Like a normal D20, I'm not actually sure, yeah, it would be the obsidian symbol to be the 1.
Yeah, you can still roll
it,
there'll be a We're
yeah. I'm going to use the box set.
Yeah, use the box set.
Yeah,
D20.
All right.
You rebel.
Fine. So yeah, it's perfect.
Still,
nice.
Still
yeah.
working.
Yeah. So just like so that he can't actually like he wouldn't see it coming and it's going
yeah.
under his foot as he steps.
That's hilarious.
Nice. So it's there, it's in position.
Yep.
Is it like how many steps from the top?
His foot's coming down on the step.
So like on the first step after the landing kind of thing. Okay. So he gets to the landing, he hasn't stepped onto the mirror just yet.
How big is this mirror?
Oh, it's just a hammer.
It's
very
small. But he's gonna.
Yeah,
he might be halfway. He might be half in half.
Well,
in.
No, but I mean, there's something dimensionally strange about it because
I put it on
you
the girl's
put a
head
whole person
yeah.
through
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
Even though
if you could go like this.
Yeah.
Dunk, dunk, dunk. He's halfway through.
Yeah. So he's swinging something above his head, like
he's a cowboy.
Mm.
No, like a sling.
Oh, he's a cowboy.
Yeah, he's wearing
his tie.
and this sling above his head seems to be like on fire. Like the whole
Ooh.
Thing from his hand all the way up to the end is swinging around this thing of fire. And he throws it down the gangplank towards.
Mm.
One of you, I don't know.
Does his foot catch in it while that's happening?
Well, the only person
he's on the landing still.
Oh,
he hasn't stepped onto the stairs
okay.
yet. Who? I guess he can see you, can't he?
Well, I'm closest to the thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
So he slings it. He slings it at you, and you can make a dodge.
Oh, absolutely.
If you wish.
Speed
is 11.
So you can use effort if you want to get out of the way.
So these things are called fire claws. For those of you who've seen something like
I
this.
I want
before.
One. I must have one.
You're focused.
Yeah,
the direction.
Your eyes are like still waved, don't you?
Yeah, greedy.
Yeah,
you're
in the machine. So
greedy
yeah.
mongrel.
So I'll say I'm basically blind and incapacitated.
How? What's my dip? Considering he's flinging it downstairs.
Yeah, he's got
in a moving ship through a very small channel.
Yeah, but he's a pirate. He's got his sea legs.
Yeah.
Just wondering.
Well,
I will tell you if you succeed or fail. I think it's more fun that way.
Imagine about 4.
You succeed, you dodge, and the fire lands.
No, I use gravity. It comes directly at me, and I just go,
nice,
and fire it. Does it start burning?
Yeah, so it lands on the ground and is burning a little bit like the fire you saw on the surface when you were under the ship battle. Like it's sort of when it lands, it's like it's almost like it turns into liquid and spreads out into sort of a flame puddle on the ground. Not a huge area, just a little flame puddle.
Magics.
Right.
Oily magics.
Yeah, so it's like oil and it's in his hand and then it's
solid
in his hand and oil on the ground.
Wow.
Cool.
Okay. Does he step?
yeah. But does he step?
Yeah. Yeah, let's say he steps, but the chance of him stepping on the mirror and not stepping somewhere else on the step, we've got to make a roll for that,
okay.
surely. We've got to randomize that.
All right.
How, I mean, the mirror's this big.
I was planning to put it immediately under. I was immediately putting it under his foot as he stepped.
Okay.
So I was like.
So, yeah, I reckon you got to.
Give me a diff.
We'll say diff. Well, if you're aiming it under his foot, we'll say diff 2.
Yeah.
It's going to be a
5. You succeed definitely.
Wow.
Slide it under his foot as he
steps.
So
he steps and disappears.
Wow, your girlfriend or whatever it is.
Yeah,
like,
she's
like,
got
girlfriend.
Yeah. There's an alternative world where I've got lots of enemies.
Yeah.
They're all gathered.
One day they'll all get together and find a way.
One day we'll make like a trip and it'll be just like,
One day you're going to go like this, it's going to be in your pocket, you're going to fall over and just go,
yeah,
<it's>
like,
oh,
wouldn't,
around
wouldn't
like,
that be a problem, bone dial? Whoa. I pocket
right.
dialed an alternative moment. Oh.
So,
do the other players at the top do a sanity roll?
When they see him disappear? Oh, something like that, yeah. I think they probably stop in their tracks and kind of go, what just happened?
I want
to
think about
that. So
that
gives you guys a chance to act before they attack you. Or to figure out a way to get the power source.
Yeah. So... can I create a tendril of nanites as a sort of a rope?
Yeah, I like that. Oh, someone's done mountaineering.
And then I'm going to phase into the machine. I'm going to be the ghost in the machine.
Yeah!
Well, I raged against it earlier, so it's all
that's
good.
Right. Yeah, that's
what's
right.
The machine right.
Cool. Yeah. Superman.
Yes, and so I'm going to kind of take a running leap at the machine and phase into it mm-hmm. and try and get as far in as I can, still leaving the
do you throw it
paying,
to me?
Paying out the tendril.
Do you
yeah.
throw it to me? Cool, I can't see.
Yeah. You could put it in his hand.
I'll take anything at the moment.
Well, it's nanites. It's nanites. You'd love it.
Yeah, you come back. You can feel
you'd be
it.
Holding it with both hands and your tongue.
Oh. That's kind of gross.
Oh, come at me. Cool. I get back because you go...
like spaghetti.
Yeah.
You just pull it out with the claw. It's just like...
So what should I roll?
Oh, oh, that'd be a fail. Oh.
You just did that.
Yeah.
Not that one.
Yeah, so it's going to be... I reckon it's diff 4.
Diff 4?
Alright, so have you got skills in any of this? That you can add to it? Or spend effort at least?
Well, I can spend effort.
So it'd be an intellect thing because it's magic based, is that right?
Yeah, so yep. it's two... to... activate the power.
So it's hit activate plus if you've got one level of effort
three,
that takes a dental diff of 3, is it? And it'll cost you, you've got no edge in it, so it'll cost you 3.
Yeah. I can't put any more edge into it.
No.
Effort. Any effort.
No, you've only got one.
Just one effort.
For it.
Well, I've got this, so I can use that if I get into trouble.
Yeah,
can
does that, that can drop down the diff. I don't remember how XP
you can drop
works.
Down a diff after...
No,
the roll
no.
if you don't make it.
Well,
no,
I can re-roll the roll.
You can use re-roll. It for re-roll, but I think you can use it before your roll to drop the diff.
To drop the diff.
Yeah.
But it's mathematically better if you use it as a re-roll.
Depends on the difficulty.
Do I get any advantage because I've seen through his eyes?
Oh, yeah. So there might be
ooh,
a situation.
So he knows where
picture
he's going.
In picture.
Yeah, I guess so, yeah. Because you know where to aim.
Yeah.
Does that drop the diff?
Does it
and here's my GM intrusion.
Yeah, no, I reckon that drops the diff.
So what are we at now? 2?
Yeah,
diff 2.
Yeah.
Go for it.
Okay, so I'll do diff 2 and I'll use that as a reroll
if I need it.
Do it.
Here we go.
5
plus
1.
Five
plus
definitely
one.
Get in there.
Cool. Okay.
So you travel 3 meters through a machine into the heart of the machine, and then what are you going to do with this orb when you?
So I just want to kind of grab it and phase it into me.
Ooh,
well, what? No. I want to keep it in a vacuum. So I'm going to extend the nanites around it in a kind of a bulb
mm-hmm.
and then take it back with me. So if it's in a vacuum now, it's going to stay in a vacuum.
Hopefully.
Stable.
When we pull it out.
Hopefully.
I know it's supposed to look cool, but I started to picture a Dyson after a little bit. From
somebody
like
said that.
Orb to being
a Dyson sphere.
Yeah.
It's reliable.
Nice.
Alright.
All
so
right.
What happens?
Yeah, so you'll bring it back out.
Yep.
And the following your tether.
Yeah. Are you pulling me in?
What's that? I'm
no,
following
he's,
you.
What?
Well, he just looked back and he's like,
you are.
Sean,
surely you're watching what's happening because you're.
If I can still watch,
you're
yeah.
Still
definitely.
Watching inside
my
the machine.
My face is pressed up against the machine.
Yeah.
And you're looking, you've got that.
Like, you can see inside the machine still.
Yeah. Isn't it beautiful the way that the power and flair have kind of joined together? It's amazing. Oh my god, it's incredible. two words, what? Charades, not at this time. This is so beautiful.
This
like,
is no time for games.
You want to see this house?
Yeah,
absolutely.
Right.
Yeah.
I'm calling my new puncture wound with my polygraphy pen into the neck.
Your polygraphy pen?
It's a calligraphy punch.
Oh.
Let's go.
Chat, thank you, chat.
Chat, why do you encourage him?
Calligraphy punch.
Alright, so where are we up to, Nathan?
Thank you, VHGK.
Do I get out?
Yeah, I think you'll get
like
out
process.
Next turn.
Kind of
yeah.
Oh, next turn, okay.
Ooh.
It
takes a bit of time.
The ship's now next
seconds.
To us.
and I'm going to get the nanites to start eating through the hull.
Cool.
To form a gateway between the two. So it's
can
kind
of like a singularity thing. To
I'm going to well, I'm going to sink the ship. No, I'm going to sink the ship.
You sink afterwards.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I got like this. I start getting it and just standing at the using my gravity along with the nanites to kind of form a vacuum between our ship and the this ship. And so I'm using my nanites and my gravity and the ship's nanites, and I'm just going away. And you can see this one section of the ship kind of like going in and out with gravity. You're just like,
oh.
This is
and
a metal hull, isn't it?
That's my.
Yeah.
Then that's my. Yeah.
If you could find the frequency.
That's exactly what I'm doing.
Yeah, right.
I'm finding the frequency. So it perfectly cuts the hole. We pull the metal and we just can. But we're not there yet.
No. Okay, cool.
Cool.
Love it.
Murray.
No, it's John.
John, yeah, John.
I think I'm just kind
you're still
of
doing
in the,
still on the zone?
Yeah.
Or I'm going to pull my mirror and have a look and see what.
There's a very confused there's a very confused looking
phase four
pirate covered in tattoos
wondering
how he got
and an angry woman behind him going
no explaining it to
this guy's an asshole.
We have to find him.
Oh, that'll be hilarious.
Can we play those characters?
When there's enough of them.
Cool. Cool. Hey, we don't play PC combat, remember?
No, but
cool.
You'll be the NPC.
Yeah.
Yeah, I will be. Oh my gosh. Yeah, yeah.
That's
so
cool.
GM.
The next time that Murray doesn't turn up, we'll be like, yeah, let's play that game where we kill
Murray. Yeah. I reckon you GM.
Oh.
And then you can be yourself.
I can be. Yeah. Oh, yeah, that'd be great.
This is
okay.
All
okay, so I'm going to. So, is there any noise from upstairs?
Oh yeah, they're right there. They're about to come down.
You
the
literally
stairs.
Went,
yeah, yeah,
and then you looked up and they're coming down the stairs.
Are they ropes? You want a singularity detonator?
Yeah.
I guess the side of the hull. Or
something. I was gonna do the side of the hull when the nanites are coming through.
Or just throw it upstairs.
Is there ropes holding the gangplank in place?
Oh no, it's all metal.
It's all metal.
It's like the inside of a
submarine. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, so a calligraphy pen full of blood will be pretty slippery, though.
Yeah, I guess so. In the middle.
MacGyver.
All over the stairs.
Just.
But really, stylishly.
I will use the blood of your friend.
Stylishly, and it sort of says, "Slip here."
Slippery surface.
Yeah. Ooh. Careful, slippery surface.
All right. As you do that, one of them reaches you and he slings his fire claw.
He's got a fire claw at me. Four plus one.
Ooh,
oh,
yeah.
Just a four, sorry. Four two pips. Yep.
Yep. So his fire claw somehow just singes across. You duck and it
yep.
flies just over your head.
Oh, there's that lovely copper smell of burning blood. Lovely. I don't know why I use lovely, but I've been watching too much Game of Thrones.
And now it sort of splashes down pretty close actually to you guys, but doesn't hit you.
What's that, huh? I don't care.
And,
you're just like...
I don't
so there's sort of these two puddles of fire at the bottom. And a third one...
How intense is the fire? Is it enough to sort of melt steel, or is it just like regular fire?
Just regular fire, yeah. Another one starts coming down the stairs.
Okay.
Let's see if it slips.
Sweet.
Do you want to roll? I don't know what you roll there.
What's the difficulty of it not slipping?
I reckon we'll make it I'll make it diff 2. You've pretty much covered the stair.
Yeah. With their friend's blood. Love it. 3.
Yeah. He slips and falls down the stairs.
Nice.
In an ungainly manner.
Oh,
and you're at the bottom of the stairs.
Yeah. But I'm on the wall
on
the other side, just like
cool. So you guys.
He's pulling me out?
Yep. So yeah, you get out.
Okay.
You're back in
I'd like to kind of unceremoniously be dumped onto the floor like
yeah.
kind of like I've been born, you know.
Yeah.
And I kind
reborn,
of get up and
reborn into your new family.
And yeah, you've got this oily like you're sort of all wet and oily from passing through the pipes.
Keep away from him.
Have you got it?
And then you're slipping away, but you're still lifting up the head.
So it's is it still in my nanite vacuum ball?
Vacuum ball.
Okay.
Coming to shops near you.
Are you holding him back from like?
I said yes, but we can't look at it until we get back on the ship.
Where am I?
No,
get us back on the ship.
No.
Yes.
No. No. No.
Oh, dear.
Don't get between me and you, Monero. It doesn't end well.
So what happens when it loses its vacuum seal?
That's what I'm happy.
You might find out later.
That's what I'm worried about.
But the engine has slowed down and stopped working.
What's wrong?
I was listening to the sounds of it slowing down.
Yeah. There's a bit of shouting from up on the deck. They've noticed, I think, that their propulsion system is
Scotty, what's going on?
Stopped
around
and they're dead in the water.
Right.
That's the right terminology, isn't it?
Yes, yes. Let us leave the Fortress of Punditude, is what I've been asked to call this ship. And head back to the Andrew.
I just go like this. At this time, I kind of like the metal kind of clinks.
Andronauts away!
And I just go, and then I just push the metal aside.
Which metal?
The metal from
the
side
hull?
Of the ship.
The hull you're making.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
So I pull the hull, and then as the guys turn around, I kind of like push it in the general direction of the gameplay, just in case anybody's there, and then just go straight through the ship and rush to the engine room.
Cool. So you guys run with him?
Yeah.
I want it!
I'm pulling you over.
He grabs it, you just phase it through his hands and then run with it.
Well, I'm going to stick the orb on top of my head.
Oh, nice.
And the nanites can just sort of sit there and then I'll run down the alleyway so that you can see it.
Cool, cool. One of the fire claws is thrown after you.
Okay.
Who's at the back? Are you?
Me.
Murray,
where have you gone?
I'm sort of at the side of the stairs.
Oh, so did Murray.
Oh, yeah.
Murray.
So, yeah.
Another
one. They throw another one at you.
Five.
And they miss again. You're rolling really well.
What's the deal?
Yes. The comment was that there should be female NPCs by now because I'm rolling so well. But, so I'm larger. So
the pirates are sort of gender nondescript.
Yeah, they could easily be all women. Yeah. Well, what I do, I'm the following up, I'm last.
Yeah.
I pull out my singularity detonator.
Mm-hmm.
And I run through the hole.
Yeah.
And I throw the singularity detonator behind us.
Awesome.
Andronauts away!
I go like this. I get in the engine room and I throw my necklace as one body then just falls to the ground.
Nice.
And the second one lands on it and I just go... and then just... and just fly us away. And the hole that the nanites were holding just starts filling with water.
Yep. And then there is...
a singular explosion.
That was a tiny little explosion.
Yeah, that was it was much bigger in my mind.
Much better.
There we go.
We should check it.
Oh, can we breach now? Can we breach?
Yeah, we got this.
Like a giant whale.
No.
We go like this
and
come
twist
out.
And then twist
midair.
Yeah, nice.
And come back and facing and go back towards the Iron Fist.
Right.
As it's known.
And we don't have seatbelts, do we?
No.
Okay.
No,
I do.
I've got
my little... No, my second body does. My original body does.
The other one's like fluffing.
Yeah, just like... Right. But yeah. So then we go back and there's fire all over the water, which we're just flying above at the moment.
Oh, yeah. So yeah.
Is there smoke on the water too?
The ship that you exploded the singularity detonator is like... What's the word?
Well, I was reading a reading.
Flipping it?
I was reading a newspaper from 1941 talking about the Bismarck, and it said she flipped over and cracked in two.
Yeah,
there you go.
That's perfect.
Right.
Well, the whatever it was called, the
Fortress of Punditude.
As
the Pundonomicon. Oh, that's awesome. Pundonomicon.
sort of flips over.
You've already lost your sanity reading that one, mate.
Flips over and cracks into.
What are you talking about? I'm the author.
And there are all these fires on the ships in your fleet where these much larger versions of these fire claws have been fired by these sort of catapult things.
Yeah.
And they're hot enough to melt the metal of these ships and do serious damage to any crew that they land on.
Wow.
A little bit like napalm. It sort of sticks to people and objects.
Yeah. Vietgon.
Agent Orange, yeah.
Nice. Oh, so many.
Yeah. And
Operation Rolling Thunder.
But the pirates' ships, the other ships have also been defeated by the rest of your fleet. You've done your bit and taken down one of the three.
Okay.
The other two have also been sunk.
Oh, right.
By the Republican.
By the true heroes.
By the true.
The Republican.
Yeah, I mean, you guys aren't.
We were really just after a power core. We really didn't care.
Yeah, it was cool.
Let's go to the forest. That's what we're here for, isn't it?
Oh, what praises are being heaped upon us by the Velvet?
Oh yeah, through the
So King Laird himself gets on the telepathic communication system, however that works.
Is this working? Can you hear me? Is the sink off?
It's basically Twitch.
Yeah.
Yep, and he says to Exy, I guess. Mm-hmm. Since you're the
I fire it out.
Fire it out across the speakers.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And he says, "Well done. You have done yourselves very proud. You'll be richly rewarded when we return to Garn."
Mm.
That's good news.
We're not gonna go back.
We'll be richly rewarded when we get where we're going.
So the fleet I mean, the damage is serious in some ways.
Yeah.
But it's not like the ships were going to sink. But the attack of the pirates is really to deal with the crew, and then they take the ships as plunder. Mm. So they don't want to sink them. They just want to cause surface.
Well, that backfired on them. They haven't sunken.
Yeah, so they're not. Yeah, that's why they use the fire claws as their kind of
weapon. Does the fire burn underwater?
Well, it
start a forest fire.
Yeah, it certainly floats on the surface.
Ooh.
Yeah.
No, don't go, yeah. I go, no. I want to keep it pristine.
Someone wants me to be attacked by the incarnation of my own puns, like a pun creature.
That thanks, would be an
JG.
Undefeatable.
Undefeatable
you'd organism.
You'd have to defeat it with high literature. With poetry. With Wordsworth.
With good jokes.
With Wordsworth.
With good jokes.
No. It'll be like all the dads lined up and then being attacked, so all the mums would have to be the ones defeating the pun creature.
Right.
Yeah.
Sarcasm.
Nice.
The plundered.
Cool. So you guys are going to... Well, the fleet's going to steam
on
to the west, if you want to...
Right, yes, we should follow.
Follow.
Are we going to follow under?
No, we're going to go up top. We've now got the power source.
Yeah.
Oh, well, that means someone has
I'm
to sacrifice
your hand where it's so beautiful.
Can you rig us up a vacuum?
I'm going to try and using the nanites on the boat, because there's much more of them, going to create a vacuum seal and then kind of move towards the engine. And kind of just take it around the top, and then your ones go out and create this perfect vacuum with this gold sphere. Liquid, almost.
And you're going to sort of investigate,
scan it with
some
all
other
the
time, or?
Yeah. But it starts. It feels like the energy is actually coming through to the ship anyway.
Cool.
It's not like I don't have to do anything.
Yeah. Maybe you can find some way to rig it up.
Oh, jury rig
it.
Jury rig it.
And then your ship can have power while you're not plugged in.
That would be good.
That'd be
handy. That would make you useless.
The aim of every PC to make themselves redundant.
We'll be back in 5.
Yeah.
Actually, should we take a break there?
Yep.
Yeah.
That's a good time.
Wicked.
We'll do one more sesh.
Please. Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Gorgeous.
Awesome. We'll be back soon.
Thank
Very
you guys.
Soon.
should go live while you were in.
Hey guys!
Oh, we're live!
No. Oh, we are.
Hi.
Oh, you did go live without me.
Wow.
Hey y'all! Just
we tried to go live before Murray got back to the table, but we were too slow.
I was too quick. They wanted at least 1 minute without puns, and I wouldn't give it to them.
That bathroom break that you had, though, oh my gosh, it was beautiful. We just sat in silence, made normal conversation.
Awesome. Yeah.
Well, when y'all didn't have a dice roll till an hour, I expected it, to be honest.
So we had to form... where are you from, Threepod?
We were basically forming a new party.
Yeah.
Because, most of the characters hadn't...
And we haven't played for 2 years.
Didn't know each other and hadn't played together, and we hadn't played for 2 years. So... It's been a bit slow.
I blame bad GMing, really.
Yeah. That's my fault.
I drove an hour and a half to be here and you're blaming me.
Anything that's wrong with the game is Johnny's fault. Anything that's wrong with the tech is Nathan's fault.
Alright, so
there's pun problems.
Well, greetings to Alabama then.
We're gonna edit.
Hey y'all.
I'm gonna insert
nice.
A picture over Murray's. Alright.
Alright. So, let's keep this thing moving. So the fleet with you guys, I guess, back in your position at the head.
Hello, Arkansas. Ooh, they're telling us all where they're from. It's
that's
great.
Lovely. Yeah, we're gonna fly west or sail west.
Fly west.
Yeah, to the New World if you can. And
so it wasn't the islands under the sea.
Oh, okay.
You misled the entire Garnish fleet. You made that Garnish superfluous. It's just going to be pushed to the side of the
Boat. Yeah, so are you scanning and watching and...
Opening a hole where Murray's character is.
inventing the ejector seat.
You know that door that opened that he came back through?
That one?
Yeah, I think I try and open that one again.
So you've got a sound effect for ejecting me?
Yeah, it was good though, wasn't it?
So I'm going to be scanning the ocean and scanning ahead. Also seeing the damage on the ships, if there's any real bad ones, because we've got room for crew.
Salvage. No, what? Sorry. What? Yeah. So.
Is there any ridiculously damaged, very high value ships that might have Numenera on board?
The damage.
We are cold pirates if we're going to salvage our own
fleet or the pirate fleet.
Pirate fleet.
Oh, they'd sunk down into the branches of the trees below.
And our ships? Is there anyone, people we can help?
Yeah, probably. I don't know. You could try and make yourselves useful. I don't know what you'd do exactly. They've come across these pirates before, having sailed as merchants up and down this coastline.
Yeah, we're fine.
So they know how to repair the damage. They know how to put out the fire claws, so they stop further damaging.
Okay, well,
probably
I'll
throw
just,
sand on them or something. Mm-hmm. Don't
they? I'll be a hero and fly forth.
Yeah.
You'll be a hero.
Scanning as you go, like this.
Chat, can you actually hear that? I'm just curious.
Ooh. They can hear the scanner.
Can you hear the scanner?
Yeah.
Mm. Try it again, ready?
No, we're going to try it again. If they didn't hear it, they didn't hear it. So, you managed to pick up in your scanning that there is something quite large coming up, sort of out on the horizon.
Yep, they can hear it.
Barely make it out, but there seems to be a very large metallic object up ahead.
Is it moving?
No. Mm.
Is
it Numenera?
Yes.
We must go. Boost power. We should be there by now. Let's go.
Are you going to fly ahead of the fleet or are you going to...
Slightly.
Go?
Yeah, in
scout.
The same pattern that
yeah,
I was
yeah,
doing.
Yeah,
let's scout
pattern,
forward.
But
towards
not at
the
full
Numenera.
Speed ahead. Cool. Yeah, so you fly on. And as you approach, it becomes obvious that this... object is an enormous, basically some kind of a shipwreck, I guess.
Oh, cool.
But not of any recognizable ship that you've seen. It might be might not necessarily even be an ocean going vessel. It could be a flying vessel for you know, but it's huge. Think like Star Destroyer kind of.
Are there any holes in its hull that we can
It is massive.
What state of decay is it in?
It's pretty decayed. It looks
has it got
millennia old.
Growing on top of it like an island?
Like coral and...
Well, even on top of it, is there... is shrubbery?
Yeah, I suppose there's little bits of... Yeah, it's nothing... There's nothing like... You know? There's no kind of animal life or anything. There might be a couple of birds roosting on it or
two
lichen growing on it or whatever, but it's not... Yeah. There's nothing particularly exciting. It's been there for a long, 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 long time. So it has formed a little bit of an ecosystem, I suppose.
Okay.
Yeah, that would happen.
That's cool.
Wherever it was.
Yeah.
Are we agree?
Yeah.
Mm.
So there's an ecosystem.
Yeah.
Are we talking temperate ecosystem?
All right. I scan it with the ship and check the memory bank of the ship to see if it's ever...
It doesn't have a memory bank. It's not of a technology that you seem to be able to communicate with, or it's so old and extinct that it doesn't have any
recognizable features.
Recognizable data.
I fly towards a place where we can land.
Sure, cool. And the fleet are coming up on it as well. They're very interested. They didn't know this was here. No one's ever.
Everyone miss it.
Do you want to
ask
for instructions?
You're like a week.
Oh, yeah,
we're a week
from
there.
Cool.
You've been sailing for days and days and days. And I mean, people might have been this sort of distance west, but maybe they went a bit north or a bit south at this point
back.
And didn't actually come across.
Yeah, they never returned from that awful
this
place.
Well, they didn't scan
thing.
Most
of it's underwater.
Oh,
like
right.
There's not a lot above.
But what we.
But some of it seems to be poking up, and with your scanner, you can see that it goes down.
I also let them know. I let the fleet know. I also let them know that there's coral on the, and it's. They probably won't be able to get the ships right up next to it.
You can get pretty close though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool. So I go out and find a place to land on top and land the ship in a very gentle manner.
All right. As you land your ship, there is a... Well, hang on. I've got a picture.
Mm.
That's a way more fun way of doing this, isn't it? It's in page 239 for those playing along at home. This thing.
I know what that is.
Is that player knowledge?
Comes up.
That's player knowledge.
Player knowledge.
Do you want to take a photo of it and put it on the stream?
Do you have a name and I can just type it up and get it?
Yeah, it's just called a
Dread
Destroyer.
Destroyer.
Yeah.
So it surfaces and rises up above the surface.
Don't read the rules.
I'm not.
The stats, just look
it
at the
looks.
Picture.
It looks like something out of Ghost in the Shell.
It does. It's very, very cool. And it sort of rears up behind the shipwreck. So you sort of haven't seen it because it was on the other side, and it's huge.
Oh, right.
And it sort of comes up suddenly to meet you.
Can the other ship see
it? After you've already landed. And they, as it comes up, they'll be able to see
it
too. Like I said, the shipwreck that you're on doesn't stick up that high above the water level. High enough that you can land on it and there's shrubs growing on it, but not like a mountain or anything.
This looks like some kind of pet. We must make friends with it and train it. I think we may have found some Numenera!
Yeah.
Let me off just here. I'm sure we'll be completely safe.
The flagship, the Iron Glove, sends out a very...
That's so screwed.
Very scared, very worried signal saying, "Oh no! I believe I know what this is! This is a Dread Destroyer! We must flee immediately!
Everybody go!
Do not engage! Run for your lives!
Wait, it's a pet! Let's go find and play with it!"
So they seem particularly concerned that this thing is incredibly dangerous, even with a whole fleet of ships. They are turning and running.
And scale-wise, like, it's massive.
Yeah, I think I've got... So it probably says the
feet.
Size somewhere.
Isn't there a scale in the book?
Is
like
it a ship or a creature?
The old Call of Cthulhu book used to have.
I think it might be a blend.
So I can talk with it.
Yes, you... Well...
You can talk
it
with creatures.
It doesn't say how many feet
he's,
long
he's
it is.
It's a blend of the two.
Sorry.
Yeah.
It's huge.
Say it's gigantic.
It is, like, very, very large. It's not quite as large as the shipwreck that it seems to live in, all beside. But it is massive. Bigger than your ship, easily.
Right. There it is. In the,
it's...
Yep.
It's the second biggest thing ever known to be in this world.
Right.
Okay. Yeah. It's bigger than any of your ships. It's
bigger than Ben-Hur.
It is frightening.
Then we ride it like a chariot horse.
Perhaps if we land, I will communicate with it. Yes, I think that would be the sensible option.
Is it broken down, or was that just...
No, it moved, didn't it?
No, it surfaced when we landed.
Yeah, when you landed, it surfaced and looks...
Like
it
sensed our vibrations.
Okay, good vibration.
I'm going to immediately just get power and just fly
forward
and then
dive
underneath the water and start moving forward as fast as I can.
Towards it or away?
Towards the fleet. Because we were...
You're going to run away.
Yeah.
What? Where are we going? Why are we... I'm going to start pressing on my windscreen.
All right. The Dread Destroyer
doesn't do anything.
Here's the turnaround button.
Fires a missile. It might be at you, but it misses you, and it hits one of your ships in the fleet behind you as it flees. So maybe it was just aiming at them in the first place. And it just explodes. I don't think I have a big enough explosion.
Running away. Running away now. Running away.
That'll do.
So this thing is like a...
Explodes, and the ship is just blown to smithereens in one hit. Just gone.
You have spooked it! I told you we should approach it slowly.
I'm going to take...
Better under the water?
Yeah, but I'm going to look back and start looking from behind using the rear sensors,
yep.
Just scanning the crap out of it to get as much information as we can about it.
Yeah, we scan the crap out of that thing.
Yeah.
Don't worry about the destroyer.
We scan it.
Don't worry about the destroyer. Scan the island. Scan the...
But that's what it is. It is the island.
No, no, no. The island.
No.
It's guarding the shipwreck.
Yeah.
Oh.
It's its own entity.
I start scanning the island.
Yeah.
Cool. We scanned the crap out of that island.
Yeah, no, I made the scanner noise. Didn't you hear it?
Yeah, that...
Over the sound of the battle?
Scanned the crap out of it sound. It's not like just... Not the surface scan.
You think...
Oh, yeah, that's better.
Repeat. You reckon we could find some kind of controlling device inside the shipwreck?
Perhaps we can find a hole at the bottom and enter in from underneath and then make friends with it later.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
Well, there would be lots of Numenera inside this island.
I'm thinking that... If it's guarding the shipwreck, because it only surfaced when we landed.
Not guarding?
No?
Not guarding.
I think we make our way back to the shipwreck and let the fleet cope with...
Yeah, okay, fleet. We'll do that.
Yes.
So you're going... Where are you going?
We're
under the water already. We're
diving very low and kind of like going across the top of the trees.
Oh, you're weeks away from the forest.
Okay,
weeks,
so...
Days away.
Okay,
well,
so...
Time is just...
it's Numenera,
so
man.
Just going across
the sailed for a few days between each encounter.
Okay, cool.
Not minutes.
Oh, okay.
You're a long, long, long way from the coast.
Right. Yeah.
Okay. So it's why no one's come across this before.
Yeah. So
if they have, they then.
Possibly, yes.
we're really lower. I'm guessing it's because there's an island close to the floor of the sea is not as deep as it is in normal like ocean. So we're kind of like...
No, the
island is a shipwreck.
Okay, cool.
The island is a shipwreck that's miles long.
Okay, so I'm scanning the shipwreck to see if there's anywhere we can enter underneath the water.
Yeah, it seems to be that there are quite a few places where either it's like
broken.
Eroded away enough or broken as it crashed or whatever.
It's full on.
They're kind of big gaping holes in the wreck that, like, many places that you could fly inside it if you wanted. Because it's, as I said, like, scale-wise, think Star Destroyer. Like,
big
ship.
Can I open my eyes to the unseen and see if there's something that would draw me in? Like, is there something...
Like, some part of the shipwreck that's...
So I'm pressing my face against
the rin screen. There's like drools sliding down the side.
Did you say
the
rin screen or
rin
screen?
Rin screen. It's my screen.
I like it.
And
he gets to play puns sometimes.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, there's
that's
there seems to be.
You have to have a pun card. You have to have a. You have to have
one. Murray's
card
on like 7,000.
Yeah. There seem to be some, like, there's lots of stuff kind of in a few different places, like sort of some of it's really spread out and some of it's kind of in kind of caches in particular parts of the wreck.
Because we'll need to get.
But
okay,
yeah, there's quite a few to choose from.
I'm gonna lean over to where the microphone is and go, I found it all. I shall guide you. Give me direct control. I can see it with my eyes.
So meanwhile,
I go along and I give him the external senses.
Mm-hmm. I don't need the external senses. I need the way to move through it.
Mm.
I will guide you.
I will take his advice, but not give him control.
Man, someone's got control issues.
Hey, seriously. This is my...
Just because you're the ship, just means you control everything.
I give him partial control.
Okay, whoa, go. What?
Partial control. Accepted. Cool. Alright,
yeah.
So I got the windscreen wipers working. That's my job.
You can blink. You use
I can fade the lights.
Yeah, cool.
All right.
So yeah, so you guys are gonna fly in inside the wreck.
I'm a little bit more recklessly than I.
Second pun. I saw what you did there.
It's good. So meanwhile, you assume, well, actually, you can probably see on your scanners that the Dread Destroyer has gone away over you chasing the rest of the fleet as they desperately flee.
Chasing it.
It doesn't seem to have noticed that you have dived down and disappeared from its view. And I think you've evaded it and the fleet's acted as a diversion to your explorations.
Thank you, fleet. Nice.
But, you know, who knows how long before you're discovered.
Must be quickly before the puppy comes back.
Should we circle back and dock somewhere underneath? Because you did say that it was mostly.
We're doing, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah,
that's
what we're
doing.
Yeah. We're going. But we should do it where we can go high because there can be an air supply.
Yeah, so we kind of just go to a point where through the ship to where there's air, I guess.
Yeah.
Using your direction and driving.
Mm-hmm. Blinkers.
Yeah, blinkers, and then I.
So yeah, whether that's the front or the back of the ship. It's kind of hard
just
to
just following
tell,
him and his...
Whichever part of the ship is...
Following the Numenera magnet.
Across the screen is the direction which we need to
awesome.
Move.
Awesome.
No,
yeah. So you surface inside the shipwreck. And...
What do we see?
It's a really strange looking space that you're in. Like, it's really decayed, and there's sort of stuff growing everywhere inside, all this kind of moss and things that are kind of growing inside the shipwreck. Like, because you're now above the surface, so stuff that grows in the air, not in the water. You can, like, the whole thing kind of creaks. I've probably got a creaky sound, don't I? Maybe not. Anyway, the whole thing kind of creaks and shifts. And kind of, you know, doesn't seem like it's completely stable, but I mean it's enormous, so it's probably fine. It's just kind of, you can hear sort of waves splashing against it on the outside.
Yeah, if we walk on it and it completely collapses, I'd be really surprised.
Yeah, it's like been there a long time.
Can I get
yeah,
out?
Yeah, there's
get
sort
out?
Of
yeah,
there's
I'm
kind of
out.
Corridors and things. But they all go off in crazy kind of angles and directions.
Organic.
Because it's probably not on the plane that it was designed to be on. It's probably on a crazy angle. So there's sort of corridors have become shafts and staircases kind of on completely the wrong angle that aren't at all useful to you to kind of navigate. The whole thing is sort of on its side, basically.
Well,
nice.
In the ship, since the dreadnought is not back yet, or whatever it's called, I'm going to just do a, before I change to my human body, I'm going to do a huge scan to try and scan and see what's available.
A huge scan
around.
To try and scan.
No, nice. A huge scan to try and scan the inner workings, like the.
Like, right. What's the level up from scan the crap out of it? What's the next level after that? Like, technically speaking,
Cranus.
Cram the snack.
Okay, I'm just going to mute John.
We scan the living daylights out of it.
Oh, yeah. Cool. Hang on.
Don't you feel like you're, the GM's really giving you like what you want?
Giving a lot of play.
Cool.
Like,
so with your Numenera sensing and your scanning combined,
I'm using my eyes
and
to see stuff,
looking at stuff.
And you're like,
yeah, there's
I'm hopping from one foot to the other again, saying, "Let's go."
There's some good stuff.
I open the door.
Sort of I run out
up and to the east.
We go up to the east.
I tell them that telepathically, then I get out of the ship.
I stop running towards the south and start running to the north and east.
we've got like, not torches exactly, but I'm pretty sure our explorer gear comes with
glow globes.
Yeah, so I'll pop one of those.
Yep.
Yeah. We'll take some extra ones with us.
Yeah.
And I'm going to, and if we need to go up or if there's difficult terrain, I'm going to hover us.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I'm going to get my little hover platform that I got in the first game, and we'll all jump on the hover platform.
Ooh.
And then we can go upstairs easy.
Yeah,
like it's a flying, basically, think of like
a tensor's floating disc.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah, right.
Or like,
all right. You just do it first.
So, who's in the lead? Who's leading the way in this?
I will.
In this
I will probably, it'd be hard for me not to.
Yeah.
Like, I think I would be straining at my leash.
Do you have a leash? Maybe you should
make it. Sweet, he does have a leash. A nano leash. I tie it to my belt.
And you can kind of sniff him out like the explorer.
I'm a truffle!
So, yeah, you're kind of going together.
What's that
point? And are you kind of just following single file or spreading out to look around? Or?
Yeah, on the disc.
Oh, you're all on the disc.
Yeah.
Ah, yeah.
Floating
up these shafts and up into the east. Cool. It gets really dark, and
isn't it already dark?
Well, yeah. I mean, it stays.
No, it was dark before. Now it's really dark.
Now it's really dark. It's really scary.
Really scary.
Yep. So you're
it's
kind
darking
of
the crap.
You're going up through this. Through these corridors and shafts, and you find your way into like this big kind of cavernous space, kind of like the size of a, I don't know, like a warehouse, I guess.
Like right.
A
small moon.
Yeah, and in this space, you find a whole lot of loot.
Can I just pause?
I tie the leash to the wall so that Rick's stuck there.
I missed 3/4 of the stream. It started at 6 a.m. Glad you're still here. Looking forward to see what Murray did to prolong the session an hour. Anyway, sorry, go on.
Cool. So yeah, so you're exploring, you're looking around. Do you want to kind of
fan out a bit, in the
Look around. There's sort of boxes and things to look in.
Are there particularly smelly things that smell really good?
Yeah.
I'm going for them.
Cool.
I'm gonna go and try and replace my cipher. Because I used it.
One of
looks
the
cipher. Oh, cipher, yeah.
I've used mine up. I want more.
I've used the cipher up as well.
236 in Chicago. Oh, son of Rally, you're so good. He said loot. He did.
No.
All right.
No.
Murray,
woo!
I have a GM intrusion for you.
Nice.
If you would like,
I would like it.
As you
always
explore.
I explore.
I'll give you your 2 XP. You can give one to a friend.
Justify with. Why are you giving it to him?
Because we're together.
You're gonna give him like a story thing of why you like it. Is it because you think your scanning is amazing?
Well, he probably scanned us
like
and sent us in the right thing, and he gave us his floating disc.
Yeah,
so you're digging around in a dark corner of this room
with flannel with
and you find you sort of reach in for something
and it reaches
and your hand gets stuck.
Okay.
And then you try and kind of get your hand out and you just sort of get more and more stuck in this sort of sticky
goo
substance.
Oh,
right.
Okay.
That's grabbing onto you. It's incredibly strong. I guess kind of like big kind of bands of sticky rope.
Right.
That
cool.
are all kind of
cool.
stuck to you and wrapping around you.
Nice.
And this creature hisses at you and starts climbing across towards you. I might have a sound for it.
Cool. Yeah. So is it coming from where it's stuck to, or is it separate?
It is.
Yeah.
Nice.
So you are being attacked.
Okay.
And you
it's
will
definitely
need
attacking
to...
me. It's definitely attacking me.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So it climbs across to you, across, and I don't know how much you see. Are you holding a glow globe or anything? Or?
Yeah, I suppose I've got a glow globe.
I think we'd have to because we
when
it's
you
so
do
dark,
darkness,
otherwise, yeah.
Because it's
probably,
really dark.
Like
not
we,
dark.
It's just it's yeah.
So what you
it's
see is
darkness.
A sort of a. It's a cross between a crab and a spider, I guess.
Okay.
A spider crab?
Yeah. No, it's called a ghost crab. And, yeah, it's sort of a little bit like our friend Flair.
Cool. You got a picture?
No, I don't.
No picture.
It's sort of hard to make out.
Okay.
It seems to sort
of
move out of phase a little bit. And
I want it as a pet.
Shifts between your reality and another and kind of goes invisible and then suddenly appears slightly closer to you.
Licks
flickers in and
out.
Hello,
boy. It doesn't look friendly.
Okay, cool.
I'm going to call you.
And it's climbing towards you.
Okay,
menacingly.
Okay, cool. I unfurl my anguish whip.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just going to dangle it in front of it so that it's going to walk into the, even in or out of phase, it'll walk into the anguish.
What's the anguish whip?
Sure, I have an oddity which says anguish whip.
If it's an oddity, it's probably not going to do anything serious, but it'll...
Could cause some anguish, hopefully.
I don't know. Someone have a...
Johnny...
I'm on it.
Oh, look at that. Searchable.
Yeah, is that something
you probably
searchable
yeah,
it's better.
No match. PDF. Mm-hmm.
Anything under anguish?
I don't think it's an oddity. An anguish whip sounds like a cipher.
Okay.
Yeah.
Could be a cipher. Nothing?
You just wanted to use it.
Yeah, because I had anguish written down under artifacts and oddities.
I'm going to, just while Murray does that, can I just, and everybody else is looking out, can I just go and put my nanites that are on my body and just put them onto Murray's arm? Like
don't know that he's being attacked yet.
Okay.
Yeah,
I think,
it's all happening quietly.
Because you're spread out and he's just gotten stuck in this thing's web.
Because I've got a two-headed cat fetus in a glass jar is my one oddity. Then I have a purple sap and anguish whip, my transportation mirror, which has been fabulous for us so far. I have a spike which locks into the air, which I can't use at the moment too much. But, okay, anguish whip's not working.
Yeah, well...
Can I squirt my purple sap in its face?
Yeah.
I'm blinded.
Yeah, go for it.
Pin it to death.
Yeah.
Cool.
I'll Murex shell its... ink it to death, that's what I'll do.
Yep, it does nothing. You don't even have to roll.
Anguish Whip was a cipher.
Okay.
You found it in the floating tree.
Oh my god, you guys are amazing.
Yeah.
Seriously?
Oh my gosh, you're amazing.
We love you.
Was
oh
a
my
cipher.
Gosh.
Three pod, you just got an internet point.
Absolutely.
You get XP.
Fabulous. I don't know how we send
that
to Alabama, but absolutely. Golly gosh, man.
How do you remember
that when we played the game?
Wow,
that is
maybe
amazing.
It's attached to the creature that I created.
So now, come on, you GM that one. Tell me what my anguish whip does, because nothing's coming up.
Well, it made me think that maybe it's...
I think there was something that was wrapped around our middles or something, wasn't that? It was like, I can't remember.
The creature that attacked you in there, maybe.
Yeah.
You were on the platform for, maybe.
Yeah.
I'll have a look. Anyway.
What does it do?
I don't know.
Two damage.
If it's an artifact.
Anguish whip. Yeah, I wouldn't
know
as artifact.
I can tell you what it is. I think, and correct me, chat,
because
you probably know. I gave each of you a item which transforms into... you got a device that actually it controls your platform. Others got like a flaming sword type thing. So it does the standard damage that a sword does.
Mm-hmm.
which is four. I think 4 damage,
four.
And then it has a small effect on top of it.
Okay,
so
cool.
That effect might be that Johnny, that involves anguish, so pain in some way.
So
yeah.
Before the purple settlement, which did nothing, I've got that, which is causing.
I mean, 4 damage for a whip already is really high.
Yeah.
So I imagine it's probably.
I think
thorns and stuff off it, and
So the. Well, it's going to be really difficult because you're in a bit of a weird confined space and you're already half pinned by the web.
Mm-hmm.
You only got one free hand,
mm-hmm.
so it's sort of hard to... be hard to wield a whip in that context.
Well, I was just going to hold it, so
and
walked into it.
So how are you holding your globe?
Well, I have to let go of the globe when I go for the thing.
So
the
you just
globe
drop that on the
wherever,
right next to you, I guess.
Yeah.
So it's probably not a problem. Cool. Yeah.
Right, roll it?
Roll it.
3. 2 pips.
You miss.
Oh, I should have decided to use my...
What is this?
You're going to use your XP?
Roll
again?
I'm
going
to roll again with my XP. And I'm going to use my Pierce. Attack Flourish. So I'm going to... Hello, my little friend. I'm going to attack with a style or a quip.
So,
plus
what is that? Like, plus 1 to the roll?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Hello, out of phase ghost spider thing.
4. As I use my might and my edge. Still missed.
Oh, still missed. Sorry.
It's dark and it's a ghost.
We hear the cries.
Yeah.
So you guys can come running.
Well, at the very least you hear, you hear, hello, my little friend. Hello, my little friend.
Is my pet back?
All right, you take...
Destroyer.
Blazes.
You take 3 points of... damage,
mm-hmm.
minus whatever your armor is.
To your,
yep.
to the might?
Might first, yep.
Yep, 3 points of might damage.
Cool.
From the web. The web sort of does something to your arm.
No.
Nice sort description. Of,
well, it basically...
something to your arm!
It's basically...
that's a t-shirt.
Okay.
The web does something to your arm.
The web dehydrates your arm.
Yeah.
So it's sucking all of the moisture.
There we go.
Out of
that's
flesh.
The effort I was looking
baby.
For.
Yeah,
baby. That's heaps of
3.5 hours.
Yeah,
you
I'm
get an experience point for that.
Yeah. I preferred something.
Like moisturizes it.
No. Yep, so you take 3 points of damage.
Alright.
To your,
demoisturizes. Demoisturizes.
My skin's
all
flaky.
It's going to attack.
Have a gimpy arm.
It's
my sword.
Crabby.
It's my clicker.
Alright, I'm going to try and pull out.
It's going to attack you with its mandibles.
Mandibles, I'm going to try and dodge and try and extract myself from the web at the same time.
Go for it.
I get a 2.
Yeah. You take 6 points of damage.
Whoa! You should not fight this thing.
No, I gotta get away. Well, I was trying to get away.
This thing doesn't look like it's out level.
So that's actually 6.
4-on-1, you might have more chance. 1-on-1 is not looking good.
Yeah.
Let's just see. Let's just see what happens.
6. Yep.
Can I run over? I've got a razor ring.
Mm-hmm.
Can I throw it at the thing I'm running over there?
At the crab or at the web?
At the what's the web?
He's trapped in
my
his
hand's
web.
Trapped in the web, and the crab's attacking
crab spider.
Which is why he can't get away, and why he's so
slice
vulnerable
the web.
To attacks.
I'll use it to slice through the web.
Yeah. Is it? How does it work?
It's just a ring, with it's like Xena's.
I was going to go for crawl, but
yeah. Cool. All right. Yeah, you can try and slash.
I throw my mighty shield.
Mm-hmm.
3.
Yeah.
Slices through it.
Yeah, it slices through it, and you're kind of...
I say,
a handful of sticky rope,
yep.
That's dehydrating me.
Probably still going to do its work for at least another turn, but it'll wear off eventually.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
All right, so then is it my turn or your turn? You go first.
I think we'll just go...
Yep.
Yeah, John.
Johnny
to John.
So I see it there. Now, it's facing in and out of dimensions, isn't it?
Yeah, a little bit.
Okay, I'm going to open my eyes to both dimensions if I can, so I
ooh,
see it across
that's
it.
Cool.
And time it for when I see it phase through.
As in when it's about to come back into your dimension.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's flickering sort of pretty quick.
I have a buzzer which shifts through dimensions, so my gun actually fires in different dimensions.
Cool.
So... I think I'm just going to try and take its legs out with my buzzer first, so I should have a higher chance, I guess, of getting the right dimension, maybe.
Yeah, big is it? Yeah, so I'll give you...
How big is it? Is it?
I'll give you an extra...
Is it small?
I'll drop the diff the, for the... yeah, they're about a meter across.
Okay.
They're not huge.
Enough,
but,
yep. So sort diff 2?
So... No.
Diff, is it diff 4 normally or diff
it's
3?
It's diff 5 normally.
Diff, so diff 4.
Wow.
What else have I got? So I can see into another dimension.
Which is one down.
So that's one down to 4.
Yeah.
Is that right?
And then the buzzer that can shift through different dimensions.
I think that's
easier to hit.
Would that affect it, Johnny, or not?
Well, no, because if you could see through other dimensions and you didn't have a buzzer that helped you with that, then that wouldn't be any use to you.
Yep.
So I'd kind of give it to you twice, one effect.
Do you want an XP? I've got an XP.
Nah, I got 2. I think I'm just going to try and shoot for it. Yeah.
Cool, so D4, yeah.
Maybe I'd spend an effort, actually. Yeah. I'd spend an effort to drop that down.
To 3.
Yep, succeeded.
Nice. Cool, how much damage does your buzzer do?
It does 2 points of damage.
Cool, cool.
But aims for the legs.
Oh yeah, it has lots of legs, doesn't it?
It has 8 if it's a crab.
Well, it's got 6 it walks on and 2 mandibles. Isn't that what crabs normally have?
Yeah.
Yes.
6 walking legs and 2 incisors.
Quickly, chat. How many legs do crabs have? It's very important.
Cool, cool. So you, and I mean, it,
so
I think
am I actually to take from speed instead of might. It just doesn't make much sense to take from might if it's a gunfire.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I might take from speed.
Yeah. And I think we'll say that your damaging of its legs sort of it stops in its tracks at least momentarily, which might give you a little more chance to scramble
8.
Away.
Nathan.
Gravity. So I'm going to go along and get my gravity, and I've got the push ability, which is 2 intelligence, and I'm going to push. Obviously, it's standing still, but I'm going to push it down onto
8,
the ground to make it so that it's much, much easier to hit. It can't move, or so it's just going to push it onto the ground so its body's like this and try to get it up. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put an effort on it as well.
Crabs are just spider mermaids.
So
what tells us.
That's intellect, isn't it?
Maybe they want me to have a social interaction with this
mermaid.
NPC, I'm not sure.
Cool.
Possible.
Crabs are related to spiders.
How difficult would that be? Or I can just roll in.
Yeah.
So I put an effort into it, so whatever it is, one less.
Yep.
And it takes 2 intellect points, so that means that I'm down. Cool. And I've got the skills Numenera, does that help? Because it is Numenera?
It's not actually.
It's not Numenera,
no,
sorry.
It's just a creature.
Just
1 with 2 pips.
Yeah,
no.
You missed.
I love your really dealing.
So
happy.
Okay.
Oh wait, did you do your thing with style and panache?
I did.
You
won't get a plus 1.
I'll always give plus 1.
Oh
yeah,
right.
That was my
hello.
So
one with 2 pips.
That's what your
2
pip actually becomes.
2, yeah.
Yeah. Still miss.
Alright. So
I tried, man, I tried.
So is it
tried and
turn?
True? No, it had its turn after me.
Oh yeah.
Tried and true.
How comes one mirror?
So I'm going to roll to see whether my mirror is going to crack.
Oh, yeah.
No.
Cool.
Cool. And, I'm going to...
I feel like this mirror is slightly overpowered.
Oh, I love my mirror, but I'm happy. Look, if the mirror... If the
that
mirror
lets
us
try averaging weapon.
If my transportation mirror cracks at any point from beyond now, I'm happy for it to happen.
No, do you know what happens?
So much good stuff
with
that. And then, if it breaks, it's like, oh, well, no, we can never find that dimension where I said everyone.
The thing is, what happens if the mirror breaks and everything comes out?
The intrusion. The intrusion.
Wouldn't that be... That would be like...
Oh.
You know, yeah, 25 adventures later. We run. We flee. Okay.
Yeah. The dreadnought, you're like...
So you're not trying to run away, you're just trying to mirror the thing?
Yeah, I'm going to push my mirror onto its...
Wouldn't that be a block then?
No, it's sort of a...
Yeah.
It's still an attack.
Yeah, sort
how
of like...
Hard
kind
do,
of
how hard do you push it against it?
Well, it just has to sort of... If it's moving, then it will sort of skitter into it. Yeah.
Do you push the crap out of it?
The crab, yeah, yeah.
The crab.
Yeah, yeah, I do. Right. I'm trying to cut down on the numbers in the other end, at the other dimension. So I'm doing this with. Take this, you little crab. I'll make you into fritters. So there's some style and panache. I'll use my pierce. And I'll use my. So I get plus one. I can use some effort.
We got
which
seven.
Brings the. What does that bring the difficulty down to? I use my effort.
Seven. It's hard to know because it's part of what makes it hard to kill is it's
phasing.
Phasing. So if it's in the wrong phase, you'll miss.
Mm. Is there any predictability to the phase?
No.
He's predicting.
Yeah.
He can see which phase it's in. Yeah. For you, it's just appearing and disappearing. Right, so I reckon. I reckon it's probably started.
Well, do you
want to
give me a percentage
five.
Roll and then a diff? What do you want
to
do?
No, I reckon it starts as a diff 5 because it can phase to dodge you if it sees you coming.
Right. Okay. Cool. All right. So that's with that 4 and 3. All right. 3.
Yeah.
And I get a plus 1. Here we go.
Oh,
is
the GM intrusion!
Oh.
I've been using all my good rolls until now.
Oh, you just rolled a crit.
I rolled
critical
a
fail.
Fail.
Critical fail.
Oh,
critical
GM
fail.
Intrusion. GM intrusion.
A GM intrusion upon my GM intrusion.
I don't know whether I should just...
Hang on, did you get a GM intrusion?
Yeah, this isn't that what this was to start with.
No, was that a serious thing, Jim? Because he would have given you XP.
No. He rolled a
Nathan and me.
One. That is a GM intrusion.
This is a GM intrusion on a GM intrusion, yeah. You're right.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's like.
So, I just drew a combat card because we haven't used them before. So
yeah,
Windows of my mind.
Says the character's armor is damaged, reducing its armor by 1 until it's repaired.
Mm-hmm.
If the character wears no armor, her shield is destroyed. If she has neither, her clothing is greatly damaged.
Mm-hmm.
Do you wear.
I have armor, it's down to 1 if that's damaged by 1.
No!
So you'll be taking. An extra point of damage every time.
Oh, lovely jubbly.
Alright, so you...
Does he get XP from that GM intrusion? Or?
No. That's a...
Yeah,
he
failed.
That's a fail
failed.
Thing. Okay.
Fail intrusion.
It's
all
a
right.
different kind of...
Is
mechanic.
It a European or African crab?
Yeah, absolutely.
Cool, so it's the crab's turn.
Crabs.
It does 3 points of damage with the web on your arm.
No, I didn't. I cut the web off.
You cut the web off.
It's sticky. It's still attached.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, maybe once it's detached... can be reducing. Maybe we'll do 2 this turn and 1
mm-hmm.
the next.
Mm-hmm.
Well, maybe it amplifies as it dries out.
Yeah.
No, because it's sucking the moisture. But
yeah,
it's
got nowhere to suck it to.
Yeah, it loses it.
Yeah,
sucking.
That wouldn't make any logical sense in Numenera.
No.
Du-du.
So do I take all my damage and might first and then go to the others, or do I spread
it
around?
Yeah,
I do it very
quickly. Alright, and it attacks you with its giant
mandibles.
I am dodging. It's got a negative because it's got the 2 of them missing from the last
gravity.
Oh, from its...
From its attack.
It doesn't have its legs missing, they just damage.
Oh, okay. Thinking
he has
sore
legs.
Snapped off.
Sore
legs, okay.
You've got to really work it if you want the DM to really give you...
I'm dodging, using my might. Oh god, I haven't got much might left to use. Yep, dodging.
You can dodge with your speed.
No, I'll dodge with speed.
Don't you normally dodge with speed?
Yeah.
Alright, I'll dodge with speed.
You take it with
might.
You
block
with
might, you
block
dodge
with
speed.
Dodge with speed.
Yeah, okay. I'm gonna dodge.
Okay.
4.
Yeah, not enough. So you take another 6 points of damage.
6?
Oh, probably minus 1 from you.
Yeah, I'm down to 0 might.
There you go.
So you take a minus 1 step on all actions.
Okay.
I think.
Yep.
So 1 plus 1 is your diff to hit with.
Yeah, so
6.
Your diff's gone up.
Yep.
Or your
yep.
actions.
This GM intrusion is quite a GM intrusion.
I think you need to make a bit of a retreat.
I think if he ran away, he might have been okay, but he keeps trying to fight.
I tried to send it into another dimension.
Yeah, no, it's a good idea.
Yeah.
Alright, so Derek.
Okay, so I'm going to pull out my spear and I'm going to vibrate the tip of my spear through the phases in an attempt to get it.
I guess you can
like the flash.
Like the flash.
Yeah, cool.
Alright.
Spear buzzsaw effect.
So I got a 4.
I reckon
you get a plus 1 because I've done things with flourish.
Okay.
Yeah,
we'll say that hits.
Okay.
Yeah,
so
it would normally be 5, but you drop the diff with the phasing.
Vibrating thing.
Because it can't dodge as easily if you're in all of its phases.
So
this is from shaking a spear.
No, phasing it in and out.
Oh, cool.
I'm
yeah, that makes sense.
I see.
He's phasing
my
spear in and out.
Shaking the spear.
So that if means that when the crab goes, one of the crab's defenses is to phase in away from the attack, but it phases across to another dimension that you're still
thinking that it's avoided.
You're still in,
actually.
Yeah. So you hit
4 points.
Cool.
It's got armor, It's absorbing.
It's got an exoskeleton.
Oh yeah, it's got an exoskeleton. It's a crab.
Cool.
So it's got natural armor.
Yeah. So yeah. All right, my turn.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to craft an illusion of bright light around all its eyes.
It's only got two.
Oh, it's only got two. How it's a crab part, not a spider part. I've got a cube size.
Are you sort of looking at it to see where its eyes are to kind of aim this attack?
It's not 3 meters large as this creature.
One meter.
Yeah, so mine's 3 meters in size.
So you're not actually aiming, you're just covering it with the
I'm covering it in the most blinding light possible.
Cool.
Yeah.
It doesn't seem to affect it at all. I mean, it lives in a dark, pitch black environment.
Yeah, I was thinking more blinding it than it was a spooky.
Yeah, but I think it's evolved to not use sight to get around anyway.
Yeah.
So the blinding light is... It doesn't even know that it's happening.
So is it blind?
It is already blind.
It is already essentially blind. So its eyes are like milky white.
It just doesn't have them.
It doesn't have eyes. So it doesn't literally doesn't have eyes.
It says, according to the rule book, that visual effects have no...
But would I be aware that it has no eyes? Is what I'm asking, because I wouldn't do an action if I knew it was pointless.
It says,
but if it looks like it's got eyes, then
it says they're blind. It doesn't say it has no eyes.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I guess I don't know, milky white. I guess I don't know.
I'll say I do it, and it doesn't work.
Yeah.
I reckon that's.
I think you wouldn't know that it wouldn't work until you tried it.
Yeah, yeah.
So
that's totally fine.
Sorry.
No, it's fine.
That's what the creature is.
Blinding.
Of course, everyone here is
blinding an already blind creature.
Yeah.
He's blinded. That backfired.
Gravity onslaught into its brain.
Cool.
Ooh.
Gravity onslaught drill activated.
Make
drill its brain. Put an effort in.
A roll.
Plus one. Never get your plus one.
Three.
So it's normally difficulty
plus
five.
Eight. So I've knocked down one effort.
So panache adds a... do we say a full step?
No, just a plus
one. Okay, cool. I feel like it should do more.
Attack flourish is cool.
Yeah, I feel like it should...
I don't think it's a whole step.
Yeah, I think
you might... Oh, the chat's making garnish jokes. Nice.
All right, come on, make a roll.
Recipe jokes.
Quick, before the chat...
Love it. Sorry.
That's all right.
Did you get your plus one?
Yeah, but there's
it's just a
two with a...
I am running away.
Good idea. Because you are really...
I'm damaged.
Damaged. All right, so you're gonna scurry away before this thing climbs on top of you and pins you down.
I advance towards you backwards. Crab.
Hey, can you just like shift it?
Cool. I think you can do that.
Okay.
It will...
A bit more difficult.
It will...
Skitter after me?
Skitter after you.
Do I take some damage from the...
Oh, you're taking one more damage.
Okay, armor absorbs that. Okay.
Derek. Oh no, wait.
Is it
trying? Oh yeah. So it skitters out into the open, chasing Murray, who's.
Okay, so it's only going to eat Murray.
At the moment,
it's Japan.
Is that such a bad thing?
Its priority is Murray.
Let's
hey,
put Murray
hey,
in
just
his
remember,
mirror.
Jakan's
it would save his life.
Jakan's not the one doing the puns. It's me doing the puns.
Oh,
so.
Okay.
But still.
I'm having trouble separating play and character.
Yeah, clearly we're trying to blind a blind creature.
Alright, Derek, what's the plan?
I'm going to try stabbing at it again.
Yeah?
Again, with the same technique.
The phase technique. So that's difficulty four.
Do I get any help from you?
You still get a plus one from
a
me.
Plus one, so,
yeah, so if you
three?
Get three with two pips, that'll be a four.
Okay. Three with two pips.
Hooray! Oh, my plus one comes in handy.
Yay.
So another 4 points of damage.
As you said, all villains milk the cow at least once.
Alright, so it sort of recoils a bit from your spear stabbing it in another phase.
Okay.
And so that gives you a little bit more distance in your running away.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Is it looking sick or is it damaged?
Yeah, it's sort of got like it's because you're stabbing it right in the face.
Yeah.
So it's kind of looking a bit like there's sort of some kind of milky white sap stuff coming out of its mouth and out of the wound in its head. But it isn't like on the edge of...
Mm. All right.
I'd like to bring down some of the roof on it.
Yeah.
That's what I was about
to do. So I was waiting for you to try that.
Yeah. So I've got a buzzer, so I'd like to fire my buzzer to where I think would be a good place to bring down some rubble. And maybe you can assist me.
Yeah, can I assist him at the same time?
Yeah, so you kind of grab any of the...
I'm just like...
Kind of try and shake it loose while he...
Yeah, I'm like shaking and nanites are going to it, then I'm just trying to pull it down on top
of it. Nice.
Cool, cool. So
everything can be solved with nanites, I reckon.
I reckon we'll make it if you both succeed on... Oh, I don't know how am I going to do that. So yeah, if you both get diff 2, then it succeeds. But if one of you fails, then it fails. Like you need to kind of be in concert.
I would like to, expend a speed
effort
to do that.
I'm on 8 at the moment. I can expend...
There's an 8.
3.
No, I can expend 3.
An edge.
Yeah. I've got 2 edges in it, so I can expend 6.
Ah.
No, I can expend... I need to push.
You can expend...
I've got 8.
Effort takes it to 5. It will expend 5 rather than 6.
What?
So if you've got 2 effort...
No. The edge just means you don't have to spend as much.
I thought you were spending 2 effort. Sorry.
No,
I misunderstood.
An edge.
Oh, yeah, cool. Hang on, what? What are you doing?
I'm just pulling.
You're doing 1 effort?
Yeah.
But yeah, cool. Okay, let's do it. So what's my diff? It was
2. You were both 2.
Two.
So now you're both 1.
1.
We failed this.
5 plus 1.
5 plus 1! Yes! Boom!
Awesome.
Take that rubble.
Yeah.
Take that wall.
It just... boom! Straight on top of it.
Yeah, but it's embarrassed now.
Hey.
Yeah, what does a blushing crab look like?
Does it
go red?
Like a crab, yeah.
Awesome. Cool.
I give a little squeal and cartwheel away.
Yeah, so I reckon you crush this thing. Like, there's a huge slab of metal falls on it.
I don't think we're gonna
say it takes... less than the damage it has left.
Yeah,
no.
Right.
It's flat. It's gone.
Okay, I'm going to loot everything before these guys come to. Mm. Especially Murray, who's
cool.
Like,
not in a good way.
Yeah.
Can we assist in healing Murray a little bit? Maybe get some hot water and moisten up his arm?
Yeah.
How does healing work?
So you can make a recovery roll.
I'll make a recovery roll.
And I'll put him on the...
You get 1d6
plus 3.
I'll put him on the hovering platform.
Ooh,
feet.
So he's the hovering platform.
Wow, your character's experience.
Yeah.
Your character's experience.
Cool. So how much of this loot are you going to take on your hover platform? How big's your hover platform?
It's... I would think it's about the size of the table.
Cool.
It's designed for taking large...
So with 4 of you on it, plus a little bit of loot.
Yeah.
I don't know how much, unless you do multiple trips.
We could do multiple trips.
We're not in any rush on this.
Well, the Dredger story might come back.
Might do, but they don't.
We're getting close to time, I think.
Yep.
Yeah. So we'll get a whole heap of stuff that whatever he smells, we'll try and kind of put on the platform. And he's like, ooh, that's one.
Cool. All right. So maybe I'll
How many trips can we make before the scanners start picking up the?
Yeah, so you're kind of keeping an eye out for the Dredger story.
The Dredger story is massive, yeah.
Yeah,
like,
you'll know it's coming
back.
You'll
know it's coming a long time.
You'll have
time
plenty
before
of
warnings.
Yeah, so I reckon you...
If it even knows we're here.
Could you roll a d20 and see how many times we can trip?
Or d100 might be better.
Yeah, I think so.
I think.
Loot.
7 trips.
7 trips.
Okay.
Cool. So, you get lots of
loot.
Hang on, I've got
loot
stats for your
loot.
You get 82 shins, which is a lot.
Mm.
Yeah, that's
something
eight.
Else, right?
I had 4 shins before.
Yeah, you get 4 oddities, 5 ciphers, and what's my D4? 2 artifacts.
Ooh.
Cool.
Okay.
So which
will...
I'll keep the two artifacts.
We'll randomize what they are from the tables in the book.
How about this? We post it on our Facebook page.
Yeah.
All right.
Facebook page!
Cool.
So
well done.
Go to our Facebook page and you can see exactly what we got.
You make
which a
speedy...
You can find no link. Oh, there is a link.
Let's go!
You make a speedy getaway in your ship after 7 trips and you barely escape the Dread Destroyer's missile attacks. Because
we were underwater.
We'll
nice.
Yeah.
I like it.
Pet.
We mark that on the map.
Oh, yeah. So,
that's right, we have a map, don't we?
Yep.
The rest of the fleet was managed to eventually... Well, eventually the Dread Destroyer stopped chasing them, took out quite a few ships, but when they kind of gotten far enough away, it turned around and came back for you. So some of them make it back to Garn, a bit worse for wear.
And we're like, oh yeah, it was a terrible experience, you know, what a waste of time, blah, blah, blah.
We
look at my arm.
Oh, by the way, we got all this stuff we happen to have on board. Do you want to trade?
Yep. Do you want to share it, or...?
Oh, we'll see how we go.
We'll
sell it.
We'll see
how we go.
Let's see what it is. Next time.
Pet Ghost Crab. I don't think I want one.
Yes. Awesome. Cool. Thank you for watching.
Thank you, everybody. Do we have time for quick questions or no?
Do you guys want to ask some questions?
Do you guys want to hang around for some questions? Go for it.
Hang out.
It's only what? 3, 6 in the morning? Some ridiculous time?
Yeah, some ridiculous time for most.
Yeah, some people have done an all-nighter, I think.
They have.
Some people are going to be like...
You guys are hardcore!
Some people are going to be like, how important is it to be, you know, punctual?
Someone said that you should throw lemons at the...
Yes,
right.
And don't forget the parsley.
Which is a great idea.
3:09 a.m.
3:09.
Pod.
What a legend.
Hero.
Legend.
She's going to make John feel really guilty.
She's got
now.
XP.
Why am I feeling guilty? I feel terrible. I do feel terrible.
I know. So do
if I could make the same time as it is now for you, I would.
Pleasure. Always.
If there's any questions, here we go. Murray and Ben from the Dab Club. Any of the rest of you have kids?
Yes, I have 2. I have a 10-year-old and a 3-year-old.
That you know of.
That he combined together to give us the mannerisms of a 13-year-old.
And that's how I role played.
Because I've got a 10-year-old and a 5-year-old daughter, so I was like, I see where that's going.
Yep.
I don't have any children.
I don't even have
just
fish.
I have 2 cats.
Yeah.
So, you know.
That's almost like children.
Will you ever play Dark Heresy, Rogue Trader, Death Watch, Only War? I would really not want to run Only War. I only have Rogue Trader, Death Watch, and Only War. I don't have Dark Heresy.
3 out of 4.
I only have 3 out of 4.
So
I'd really like to do
it.
I'd like to do an Only War. I'd love to do the Imperial Guard one. That's the 40k Imperial Guard.
Yeah, I played it. I played it a few times.
Yeah, we played one.
We played it a bit, actually.
What was the game we played that's on the YouTube channel?
Oh, Warhammer.
That's Warhammer.
That's a Warhammer.
Yeah, that edition's actually out of date now, I think.
What do we have to do to get you guys to play more superhero RPGs?
Well, we've got a superhero.
We've got almost all the superhero games, haven't we? So
we
haven't played them.
We really, really want to play them, but we just need to read the rules and do all that kind of stuff. I'd love to run a superhero game. If there's a new Marvel movie coming out, we'll run what we think the Marvel movie will be before the Marvel movie comes out.
So we have to do it. We have to do a Wonder Woman.
Yeah, so we're going to do a Star Wars Rogue One game on guessing what we think the movie will be like, and then we can play the difference. But we will be playing superhero.
That also answers Tully Darkstar's what about FFG Star Wars.
Yep.
It will happen soon.
I reckon that'll probably be the next one I GM. If I can, I think that's probably where I'll go. That'd be fun.
What's FFG?
Fantasy Flight Games.
Fantasy Flight,
But the Force...
Is Force and Destiny out? I might order that.
Master and Mutant Minds. Mutants and Masterminds. That's one that we were looking.
What did you just say? Martins and Mutant Minds?
Yeah.
Minds.
I know Ben bought it, that's all.
Okay. I'm very jealous of your schedule then, 3Pod. Very jealous. Starfinder? Oh, look, I get everything Pathfinder make and Paizo make, which is draining on the bank account. But, they've announced Starfinder. I'm sure Ben will be Starfindering.
Ben's already ordered it.
I actually don't know anything about it. Is it the sci-fi version of
Pathfinder?
Spelljammer?
But it's based on the Pathfinder universe, so it's the Paizo universe, the Pathfinder universe, thousands of years in the future.
Right.
Will we continue under the gods?
I'd like to. Yeah. The thing with Under the Gods, I think, is that we have, I think, two or three adventures that need editing, and so we can't really twitch it until we get those videos up.
Yeah.
Because otherwise the storyline's going to be a bit odd. So we've actually got ones finished that we haven't put up yet. Mm. So the story continues. Yes. So short answer, yes.
We love John too. We do.
And the Call of Cthulhu's up.
Oh, yeah, just saying how you're all really good DMs, but I really love John.
So everything that we twitch most of the time, we YouTube's convert and put up on YouTube. So
most of the time,
if you're sorry that you missed something, you can always go back. You know, I appreciate that you probably want to see it live because that's a lot of fun. But yes, we will be putting everything that we twitch up onto YouTube. So.
Yeah, and if you enjoy it, has 26 minutes before the actual video starts.
24 minutes and 34 seconds, please.
And if you enjoyed these characters, except for Derek's character, all of them have been in Numenera adventures.
Yeah, I was like, what's wrong with mine?
All the characters except for Derek's
have
been,
enjoyed this character except
have played before
character.
In prequels to this episode. So if you haven't gone to our YouTube channel, they are there. They are fun.
Cyril says, is there a place we can donate money and or RPGs to you guys?
Well, where you donate RPGs is my garage.
Yeah.
No, we don't. Do we have a donate button? We don't.
We actually don't yet.
No, we don't yet. We're planning on something with that.
There will be announcements soon based on that. So.
But my garage will still be the place to donate RPGs.
Yeah. I think that'll be the
repository. It's like.
Thank you. We do appreciate you guys saying stuff like
absolutely.
That. So thank you so much.
Thank you to Chato too.
Yes,
yeah.
Gorgeous.
You guys
and you guys are amazing to be staying up and gaming with us for so many hours where you are. Thank you. And wouldn't be the same without you.
No, it's so much fun with you. And you at least distract Murray with puns and awesome stuff. You guys have been awesome, especially that gun. What was it? Garnish?
The garnish.
And then it's
garnish.
Like Basil.
Yeah,
and
garnish puns. Who knew?
Oh, that was amazing. You guys are amazing.
Yeah.
So, what's this one here? So
you have to wander around Australia till we find Murray's garage.
No, I have a. If you're desperate, I have a post office box. But
no, he has an X on his roof, don't you?
Yeah.
So
Google Earth. I have an X on my garage roof, so I can give you the longitude and latitude, and you can find it on Google Earth, and that's me. So.
And then you fly a drone over and
drop
the donations that way.
And also, just so you know, Ben's going to be at Gen Con, and there's going to be a few other things that he'll be over in the US, so. Maybe we can do something to go over there.
It's the best to steer clear of those, is
that
what you're saying? Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Now, there's another piece of info that we need to impart to you, and that is that we got a request from a guy to share his...
Right.
Share his... what was it? Quiz? No.
A survey.
So, Ben Alsop from Birmingham in England is opening up
a
coffee lounge called the Dice Lounge, which is going to be an RPG cafe. He was really keen on getting anyone from anywhere in the world, because he's asked for ours and we're not in Birmingham, England, for their questions about what they want to play, how often they'd like to do sessions, things like that. The email is thedicelounge@mail.com.
Maybe you can type that
and there's a Survey Monkey survey that they'll do, which obviously we can't post any links. So
we can.
Oh, we can.
People can.
I didn't know that. I thought the bot would go mad at me.
It will be on the Facebook page.
Well, Murray can do that in a sec.
Oh, yeah, we'll put it on Facebook
right.
as well, because and you should definitely follow us on Facebook if you are not already.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And also maybe just reflect on how awesome it would be to have a cafe that you could go and
do
yeah.
RPGs.
Oh,
at.
We
yeah,
that.
Absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
I have often thought of Google Earth orienteering as possibly the best sport for armchair orienteerers.
Mm.
But yeah, if that's something you guys are interested in, we can work something out. But we just love you guys coming in and adding the fun to our games, and we're happy that we're able to help
you
out.
We basically feel like we're making an international community of role playing, which is part about sharing the love and the support and gaming. So love you all.
Catch
I want
you guys.
A lovely segue.
Night.
Bye.
Have
bye.
A good
day.
Evening, afternoon.
Bye.
Good afternoon, good evening, and
good night. Good evening and good night.